I've seen this really cool facade and I thought, well, can we do something like that in Revit? And the answer is yes, it's actually quite simple when you know what you're doing. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you exactly how to create this by utilizing massing and adaptive panels. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about mastering Revit, this is the best place to be. We are an Autodesk authorized training center. We offer over 150 hours of content dedicated to Revit, and we also offer Autodesk certification. So if you're interested, check it out. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. So we're just going to be starting off with this simple mass. I'm going to select it and then go into edit in place. Now, once we're here, I'm going to select the front face. So you need to use the tab key once or a few times to highlight it and then select it. And then I want to change this into a specific grid. So for example, you can go with no pattern, but what I want to use is triangle flat. So this is going to give me a flat triangle pattern. Now here you need to fix the layout. So you need to make sure that the layout is set to fixed distance for both U and V grids. And I'm just setting the U distance to 4,500 millimeters and then the V distance to 2,000 millimeters. And we're just going to be using this as a base for our facade. Now it's time to create our parametric facade panel. We're going to be doing that by going here to File, then go to New, Family, and then here I'm just going to go back into Metric, and here I'm going to pick out the metric generic, and you want to find pattern based. This is the one you want to use. It's really important, so pick out the correct one and hit open. Now, once we're here, you can select the pattern by highlighting it here on the outside, and then you select the pattern, and then you just need to switch it from rectangle to triangle flat. And also here, you can set up the dimensions. So this is going to be 2000 millimeters for horizontal spacing and 4500 for vertical spacing. Hit apply. Now this is what that's going to look like, and this is what we want for our starting point. So the first step is going to be to do the frame. So because these will be kind of next to each other, these triangle panels, I'm only going to be doing half of the frame that's here on the inside of this triangle. I'm going to go here to reference, point element, and then I'm going to make sure it says draw on face. So this is highlighted, and then I'm going to place this here in the midpoint. Once we have that, we can use this as a reference plane to host our profile. So let's go here to set work plane, pick this plane over here, go to model, line, make sure that the draw on work plane is selected, and then we can start off from here. So I'm just going to go to this side, 75 millimeters, go up by 50 millimeters, go back by 30, go down by 20, and then go back here. And I think we need 45 to kind of complete the pattern and go down. Perfect. Now, because I don't want this to be above the point completely, I want it to be a bit down. So I'm just going to go here to move, and then I'm just going to move it down by 25 millimeters, just like so. Once we have this, I can select my profile, hold the control key, select the reference planes or reference lines that go all the way around, go to create form, and this is what we have. So this is the geometry. Now I'm just going to use the tab key to highlight the entire geometry, select it, and then let's assign a material parameter over here, create a new parameter, and let's call this one the steel parameter. It's a type parameter. Okay. Okay. And that's it. Okay. So the next step is now to create the actual shape that kind of goes above this triangle, forming it in sort of like a pyramid or something. So to do that, what we're going to do is, again, I'm going to go here to reference, point element, and then I'm going to go to draw on face. And let's now zoom in to this line here. Now it can be a bit tricky to figure out what's going on. Okay, so I want this line, and then I'm going to go to SM to snap to midpoint and place a point there. I'm going to go to the other side. Again, it's kind of tricky at first. Okay, there it is. SM to snap to midpoint. There we go. And then do one on the bottom here. Again, let's see. Okay, SM to snap to midpoint. Perfect. So we have those points in place. And then also I'm going to be placing some points here on the inside. So basically here on top of this edge, and then do the same thing on the other edges as well. So that's one here. And then finally one over here on the second point. Like so. Perfect. Okay, once we have all of these in place, the next step is going to be to place one in the center and then offset it. For that, what I want to do is go here to Views, Floor Plan, Level 1, go to Reference, Point Element, and then here go to Draw on a Work Plane, and it's going to recognize our level here, and I'm just going to place this in the center. Hit the Escape key a couple of times, select it, and now here we can set up the offset. And I'm going to set this to 500 millimeters. Now, if I go back to the 3D view, you can see it's basically hovering above, which is exactly what we want. I also want to control its position from the top here, so I'm just going to use an aligned dimension, going from here to the point itself, place it there, select the point, and then make sure this says 800. So it's set to 800. We can even lock it in place if we want. And there we go. Now it's in the correct position. Okay, now it's time to start connecting these things. So I'm just going to make a selection like this. So I'm using the drag to the right. So I only select what I encompass, and then I'm going to go with these two points. Go to spline through points and then make it a reference. And now I'm just going to repeat that for a few of these points to get the shape. And this is what that looks like. And now when I think about it, I actually don't need this one. So I'm just going to delete that point and that reference line. And this is what we have. Okay, now we also want to connect these points here together so we can create a shape. So just like this, like those two, spline through points and then make it reference. And then I'm going to repeat that here, just like so, spline through points, make it reference, and finally one here on the bottom, just like so, spline through points, make it reference. Perfect. Okay, so now once we have this, what we can do is we can basically highlight like this, hold the control key, select this line as well. And then once we have three reference lines, we can go to create form. Now, it may show you a triangle or like this, an extrusion. So you just want to go with a triangle. Now, in case it creates an extrusion, you just delete that shape. You just hit delete and it's going to go back to triangle. So it's really easy. So for example, here, if I mess it up and it's this, I just hit delete and then it goes back to a triangle. And then I do the last one. So hold the control key to select all of the reference lines and then... what am I looking for? This, there we go, perfect. Okay, so once I have all of this in place, the next step, what I wanna do is I want to add some sort of a profile going on over here. So what I'll do is I'll just go with a simple point element, reference point element, draw on face, and then I'm going to place one here, and then one here, and I think one here, and that should be enough. Okay, perhaps I need one over here as well. Okay, so all of this is only to create kind of the shapes here that kind of form the structure of the triangle. So basically now you go to set work plane, pick this, and then go with a simple circle, and you find that endpoint, and yeah, that's where it's creating a circle. I'm going to go with 15 millimeters, like so, hit enter, there we go. Once we have that, I'm just going to select the circle, hold the control key, select the reference line, and then go to create form, which is just going to create like a bar going across. And now I'm just going to be repeating this for all of these point elements which I have placed. This is the result that we get, and it's looking really, really good. Now we can assign materials to all of these. I'm not going to go too much into this for now, just to keep it kind of simple and straightforward. So what I'll just do now is, once we have all of this set up, I'm just going to save this family, and I'm going to save it on my desktop, and let's call it our panel one. Then you hit save. Once the family is saved, now it can be loaded into the project. So I'm just going to load it into the project, select this pattern, and here under triangle, we have panel one, and it's now going to apply that panel all across. Now, one thing that you may have noticed, and that's that on the original project, on these panels, which are kind of upside down, or 1 point on the bottom, 2 points up, basically on those, we don't really have any material in these two spaces. So to fix this, what I'm going to do is go back here. I'm going to delete these two faces, just like so. And then I'm going to go to File, Save As, Family, and I'm just going to save this as Panel 2. So I can differentiate between those two, and now I can load it into the project. And then in this project, what I'll do is I'm just going to use the Tab key, hold the Control key, select this one, so, and then just by holding the Control key, I'm going to add more. Now, if it highlights everything, you hit the Tab key once, hold the Control key, and add that one. So I'm just going to do that here on top, and now I can switch this to triangle flat number 2. And now this one, yeah, as you can see, it only has that material on top. And that's the result that we want. And then with a little bit of adjusting and setting up the materials, so here we have that steel material on the outside, and then we have the mesh material here in between these. This is what that facade is going to look like, and this is exactly like the one that you have seen in that image, which is really, really cool. Now, if you would like to get access to this Revit project file, as well as all of my other Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.